child, along with a dream of a life. Travel the wide open road, the blinkered arcade, in search of another to share in his life. But nowhere, everyone looked so strange to him. They got no horns and they got no tail. They don't even know of our existence. Am I wrong to believe in the city of gold that lies in the deep distance? He cried and wept as they led him away to a cage. Beasts that can talk read the signs. The creatures they pushed and they prodded his frame and questioned his story again. But soon they grew bored of their prey. The beasts that can talk, more like a freak or publicity stunt. Oh, 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 oh. They got no horns and they got no tail. They don't even know of our existence. Am I wrong to believe in the city of gold that lies in the deep distance? He cried and broke down the door of the cage. By the scruff of his neck, pointing out, beyond the bounds of your weak imagination lie the noble towers of my city, bright and gold. Let me take you there, show you a living story. Show you others such as me. Why did I ever leave? They got no horns and they got no tail. They don't even know of our existence. Am I wrong to believe in the city of gold that lies in the deep distance? He cried and wept. Set out with the beast and his horns and his crazy description of home. After many days' journey, we came to a peak where the beast gazed abroad and cried out. We followed his gaze and we thought that maybe we saw a spire of gold. No, a trick of the eye, that's all. But the beast was gone and a voice was heard. They got no horns and they got no tail. They don't even know of our existence.